form of organization and name rule. So these are just, the different rules within the AICPA. The form of organization and name rule, a set of guidelines that dictate how certified public accounting firms must be organized and named. Can I just go out and say Nick Palazzolo, CPA firm? Let's see. The rule is designed to protect the public by ensuring that only firms that meet certain standards of quality and professionalism are able to use their certified public accountant designation. So can I just go create a website, nickpalazzolo.cpa? Well, the .cpa domain actually exists, but there's a lot of rules on that. Not that that's not tested. It's just kind of me going into depth on that. Like, for example, that I would need to have that website first register it with the AICPA. It needs to actually provide CPA services. I can't create a clone of eBay and start selling things and call it .cpa just for the cred of saying CPA. No, there are rules with that. But with your CPA firm, if you're actually going to call your business Nick Palazzolo CPAs Incorporated or whatever that may be, yeah, you got to register with the AICPA. You got to follow their rules and everything. So this rule talks about how we are going to appear as a business. Because CPA firms are a business, right? You're not going to do this if you're not getting paid. As good as it may sound to be out there and just doing the good work of the AICPA, no, no one's going to do this if you're not getting paid. The form of organization and name rule requires that any firm that uses the CPA designation in its name must be a corporation, partnership, or sole proprietorship. Well, you don't really need to memorize that, but you know that's organized and operated in accordance with the rules set forth by this code of conduct. In addition, you have to register with the PCAOB if you're dealing with public companies and have a valid license with the public accounting practice in the state that it's headquartered. Continuing on here, the name of the firm must also meet certain standards in order to be eligible to use that designation. The name must include the words Certified Public Accountant or CPA, and you have to register with the AICPA. In addition, the name must not be misleading in any way, and it's got to be distinguishable from the names of other firms that provide similar services. Right? Just be ethical. That's why I see so many firms, just Miller and Jones, CPA, just very like standard. You've got two names or maybe one name, and right, Deloitte, CPA, PwC, EY, KPMG, all those good names, just people's last names. Well, also those individual people wanted the clout back in the day. And why not? You know, why shouldn't you have that? The AICPA form of organization and name rule is designed to protect the public by ensuring that only firms that meet certain standards of quality and professionalism are able to use that good old CPA designation. These standards help to ensure that the firm is properly organized and operated, and that its name is not misleading in any way. Very good, very good. By meeting the standards, firms can make sure that they provide the public with a higher level of confidence in the quality of their service. Right, these firms are just branches of the AICPA in a way. They are doing the good work of the AICPA to have trust in the general public that auditors are doing their best job possible. Right, all these other rules wouldn't matter if we don't have a solid form of organization and name. Hey there, are you ready to not only pass your CPA exams, but truly understand and enjoy the material while studying? I know it seems impossible, right? Especially to enjoy the material? We'll do it together. Tap into the power of cpa.examprep.ai, where we've got personalized quizzes, multiple choice questions, memorization guides, flashcards, simulations, all tailored to your learning. Our adaptive study planning puts you on the fastest path to success and lifts you back up if you fall behind. Avoid wasting your precious time and money attempting an exam with a low chance of passing, because who wants that? We want to get you through this process as quick as possible. Our exam readiness prediction lets you walk in with confidence, knowing that you're prepared for success on exam day. Thankfully, there's no payment method needed to get started. So why don't you come join us? Visit cpa.examprep.ai and let's achieve your exam success together.